Everybody's recording, right? You're recording. The dog is in the house. I'm just talking to myself. I know, that's weird. There's no one else here. Can you lie down? Good girl. What's up, everybody? I hope you're doing well. Today we're carrying on with our series of psychologist trainee fails because I have a lot of these stories to share. In the most recent installment of this series, I shared with you all that sometimes sassy Marie can come out, and you're gonna get to see her in today's video when I share with you all about the time that I filed a formal complaint against my personal growth therapist. Stay tuned to hear the whole story. Welcome to Private Practice Skills. I'm Dr. Marie Fang, psychologist in private practice. I post videos offering tools I learned the hard way about starting and growing private practice so that you don't have to. You know how when you're in graduate school, or most of us at least, when we're training to become therapists, we need to do a certain number of our own therapy hours in order to graduate. It seems important to mention that I absolutely advocate for the value of these personal growth hours, but as you'll see as I get into it, I came across some personal challenges when it came to these hours. Yikes. Even though it's been 10 years since I filed it, I still have the official formal complaint that I filed against my personal growth therapist. Let's see, where to start? Where to start with this story? For my personal growth hours, I was at first seeing a therapist that was working on my campus's psychological and counseling services department. Part of my school's requirements for personal growth hours is all 40 sessions needed to be with the same therapist. So if I bailed out at session 10, I'd still have 40 sessions left to go with my new therapist, and I did not have the funds for that. It was basically not an option. Anyway, so finally one day around session 25 or 28, I brought up this concern with an ethics professor, and I'd brought this up with other professors and people in leadership before, but this professor was on the ethics committee, and so she encouraged me to file a formal complaint. And yeah, it's 5 pages single spaced.
Front and back!
So let's dive into this formal complaint and see what I was complaining about. So one item that came up repeatedly was inappropriate self-disclosure. She would talk about herself a lot. In one of our last sessions together, I was going through some of my sexual history, and as I named an incident that happened in my history, she took the remainder of the session to let me know about how she too had a similar experience in her sexual history. I confronted her on it right away because that was incredibly uncomfortable, and she said it was for my benefit because she wanted to let me know that I related to her. But I never said that I felt that she couldn't relate to me, and I just felt really uncomfortable that she shared. Cause wouldn't you? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Another thing that happened is she liked to contact me between sessions in order to apologize for a mistake she made during session. For example, one of the very first sessions together, I talked a little bit about some of my family dynamics, and she chimed in without me asking for advice. She asked me if I'd be willing to implement these changes, and I informed her that I felt like she didn't really know much about my mom, and I didn't ask for her advice. And then about 5 days later, she called me in between sessions, and she was tearful, and she said she'd been thinking all weekend about this mistake that she made in therapy. She was having trouble sleeping. She talked to her husband about it. She was crying about it, and she just wanted to let me know how badly she felt about her mistake and to say sorry. There have been times when I have circled back to my clients to apologize for mistakes that I've made with them. However, the extent of personal disclosure that she dove into to let me know how distraught she was over the weekend and that she talked to her husband about it just made me feel really uncomfortable. Like, my experience was burdening her in between sessions during her time off. Like, that doesn't feel good. All right, let's keep going. She would repeatedly say that she'd never had a case like mine where people didn't have some significant presenting issue that they needed to work through. Meanwhile, I would try bringing up different things that I wanted to process, like how my childhood experiences shape some of my not so great behaviors in the present time. I was not shy about letting her know that I wished I could have a different therapist who felt like they were a better fit for me, but she would often reply back to that statement by saying that she didn't think anyone else could be helpful to me, given that she found she wasn't able to be helpful to me, and she would frequently cite her accolades and years of experience as evidence of that. Now, the parts that really stand out to me about this experience that feel worth highlighting are less about the fact that there was such a wildly off-base therapist out there. When I filed this complaint, the ethics committee evaluated it and they determined that she didn't break any ethical boundaries, but they did validate that they found this highly concerning and they encouraged me to bring this to the president of student life at our school. So I did, and we scheduled an appointment. I brought my letter of complaint, went through all of my issues, and he said to me, "Thank you so much for filing a complaint. You are the very first one to file a complaint, and I've been waiting for years to hear a complaint from someone because I've been having a lot of issues with this person." Now, with all of that said, by the time I graduated a year and a half later, she was still very much in her same role as the director of the counseling services. But what really bugs me was I was the only one who filed a complaint, but I had heard from my classmates who met with her just how ridiculous her counseling tactics were, if I want to call it that. But no one else was willing to file a complaint. So I think this story was important for me to reflect on, to remind myself of the importance of speaking up. And in this particular moment, I found the courage to do it. I did not want to be viewed as the angry complaining lady, which I can get pegged as because I do stuff like this. So if you're in graduate school and you're finding that you're not being treated well for whatever reason, take action. Ask your classmates, your colleagues, is this happening to you too? If it's happening to all of you, all the more reason to take action. And for those of you not in graduate school, but here we are practicing in our field, if you're seeing injustices happen wherever it may be, maybe it's somebody in your office doing something that they shouldn't be doing, maybe you're seeing racism perpetuated by a colleague somehow, or whatever it might be, see what kind of role you have in speaking up against that injustice and advocating for change. That was just some food for thought. I hope you found this video helpful. If you are still in the trainee phase, know that whatever kind of crap is getting thrown at you, it's probably happened before to somebody else. We need to change our culture, and I hope you find ways to advocate for your needs rather than just take it. I hope I don't just seem like an angry, upset person in this series. Sometimes that's what I'll look like, though. Until next time, from one therapist to another, I wish you well. This video is brought to you by TherapyNotes.com. Therapy Notes helps with scheduling, notes, and billing so that you can spend more time with your clients and less time on all that back office paperwork. Therapy Notes just launched their telehealth beta platform, which allows you to meet with your clients remotely right within your practice management software. So click the link in the description box to get 2 months to try it for free with no commitment. All right, gotta go. Baby needs me. Gotta go. I don't even know how that song goes. I've never seen the movie Frozen. Can we still be friends? I'm sorry. I don't watch movies.